Welcome to Pfeiffer Vacuum. My name is Özkan Güneş. In the first video, the term pressure was used several times. But what is meant by pressure? In general, pressure is defined as the effect of a force acting vertically and uniformly on a surface. A small p is used as the formula symbol for pressure, for the force in capital F and for the surface or area in capital A. Accordingly, the unit of pressure is Newton per square meter or Pascal, named after the French physicist Blaise Pascal. But how can we describe pressure at the molecular or atomic level? Let's take a look at the closed volume V. Now let us assume that there is a gas particle in this volume which is constantly in motion. Each of these gas particles has a certain mass m and the velocity v. The product of these two quantities, mass multiplied by velocity, is called impulse. As you can see, there are random collisions of the particles with the wall of the container and also between the gas particles. Each individual collision exerts a force on the wall of the volume through impulse transfer. The result of this multiplicity of collisions is that in the case of an enclosed gas without external influences, the same pressure P will always prevail at every point regardless of the location and direction of the measurement. In this model, we have assumed that all particles are equal. In practice, however, we only have to deal with uniform gases in exceptional cases. Let us assume that there is air in this volume. Air consists mostly of nitrogen and oxygen. It also contains small amounts of water vapor, argon, carbon dioxide, and many other gases. Air is therefore a mixture of gases. Each individual gas component exerts a specific pressure that could be measured independently of the pressure of the other components. This component pressure is called partial pressure. The sum of all partial pressures is equal to the total pressure. To explain the concept of pressure, I have used this idealized model of gas. Although this is a great simplification, many physical processes of gases can be understood and also described mathematically with this so-called model of the ideal gas. But what happens if we increase the volume of the container, or the temperature and the number of particles? Don't miss our next video to find out more.